Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about Lambda Edge. So let's get started. During our front-end deployment to CloudFront, we encountered the problem of not configuring the HTTP security headers, a basic configuration for reducing the attack surface of web applications. We resolved this issue using Amazon's new Lambda Edge functions to attach the headers before the response is sent to the clients. If you request a website from a web server, the server responds with a content and HTTP headers. These headers contain information like the response's content type or the web server's version. A particular category of headers is the HTTP security headers, attached to the web server's response to enforce a specific set of security rules in the client's browser. Configuring the security headers is an essential step in securing your web application against certain types of attacks and reducing your attack surface. For example, clickjacking, cross-site scripting attacks, and cross-site request forgery can be effectively mitigated by properly configuring HTTP security headers. As mentioned before, we rely on the content delivery network CloudFront to host our front-end, which is located in an S3 bucket. This enables the commonly known advantages of a heavily reduced load time and latency by distributing to various local caching servers. However, as a security company, we are not compromising our application's security and require the ability to follow best practices, like the configuration of the HTTP security headers. Unfortunately, neither CloudFront nor S3 supports the configuration of HTTP security headers out of the box. There is the possibility of setting up cross-origin resource sharing in S3, but this does not suffice to implement all best practices. Luckily, Amazon released the relatively new Lambda Edge, which allows the implementation of an easy solution. Lambda Edge allows the implementation of Lambda functions distributed to CloudFront's caching servers and executed at the edge caching servers. Four different events could trigger the execution of the function. Viewer request. After CloudFront receives a request from a viewer. Origin request. Before CloudFront forwards the origin's request, in our case the S3 bucket. Origin response. After CloudFront receives the origin's response, in our case the S3 bucket. Viewer response. Before CloudFront forwards the response to the viewer. The last event type is the one we need to attach to the HTTP security headers. Whenever a viewer requests a CloudFront file, it locates the local cache file or fetches it from the S3 bucket or origin. Then Lambda Edge intercepts the response before it is forwarded to the viewer and executes our Lambda function, which attaches the HTTP security headers. Finally, the altered response is forwarded to the viewer. Please be aware that an error in the AWS Lambda function will cause your CloudFront distribution to crash and become unavailable. Do not use your production CloudFront distribution for the initial setup and testing. Step 1. Create the Lambda function. Open the AWS console and select the US East 1 region. Navigate to Lambda in the AWS console. Click on Create function and choose the CloudFront Modify Response header blueprint. Step 2. Configure the CloudFront trigger. Select the appropriate distribution ID for your CloudFront distribution. Select the CloudFront event to viewer response. Check Enable Trigger and Replicate. Click on Next. Step 3. Add the function. Provide a name for your new AWS Lambda function. Replace the existing code with the one below and adjust the headers to your needs. Select Choose a current role if you already have an IAM role. Or alternatively, select Create a new role from the template if you have no IAM role yet and want to start quickly. Provide a name for the new role. Under Policy, the template adds the basic Edge Lambda permissions policy. Step 4. Review. Review your new AWS Lambda function. Enable it. We intentionally did not set the content security policy header via the AWS Lambda function. Instead, we are using a meta tag in our hang file. This decision was made because the HTTP security headers configured above are not changing frequently. However, the CSP has to be adjusted regularly to accommodate the addition of new external services. Furthermore, we want to keep the CSP as strict as possible, which requires a different policy for our development, testing, and production system. Therefore, it proved easier to dynamically adjust the meta tag within the front-end development workflow instead of maintaining multiple or dynamic Lambda functions. Here you will find an example of a stringent CSP. You'll probably need to add several sources for styles, scripts, and remote connections to adjust the policy for your web application. Conclusion. You have now increased your CloudFront distribution security by attaching several HTTP security headers to the viewer response, thereby implementing a security best practice. In addition, you can verify your configuration on pages like Mozilla Observatory. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.